Gaming smartphones has become a thing for quite a while. They may have crazy gaming performance with huge battery life, maybe even with an active cooling fan inside. That could be cool. But have you ever wondered one day you can make your own gaming handheld? We can make use of an old smartphone, a controller, a cooling fan, some battery and wires, and do some proper tuning and tweaking on both hardware and software. It can not only perform better than some new flagship smartphones, but also cost way less than you expected. And today, you're gonna see exactly that. Let me introduce you what I call the Mi 90 Pro. Well, I guess some of you guys have already spotted it. It's a Xiaomi Mi 9 inside. Yeah, we crank up this Mi 9 pretty hard to make this project happen. But why we choose Mi 9? The most important reason is the chip inside. It's a Snapdragon 855. Thanks to Qualcomm, the CPU performance on Snapdragons hasn't increased that much in recent years. So Snapdragon 855 should already provide us enough CPU horsepower for modern games. The GPU, on the other hand, is a weak point of this old chip. But consider more and more mobile games are running with CPU bottleneck, it should be fine. And most importantly, Mi 9 sells really cheap in China. This unit with a cracked backplate only cost us about 700 yuan. It's about 110 bucks. Pretty crazy deal, right? To be honest, Mi 9 is not so popular worldwide. And this 110 price tag is just too good to be true for the global market. For you guys, I would recommend OnePlus 7T, which is a slightly more expensive but more available phone. You can easily find one under 150 bucks in the used market, or maybe Google Pixel 4, which has a similar price tag. Anyway, an old flagship powered by Snapdragon 855 with decent community support should be fine. Okay, so what we have right now is just a regular cheap retail phone though. To make it a gaming phone, we might have to tune it by a little bit. Let's start with the battery. One of the very common complaints about this Mi 9 is the battery life. 3300 mAh battery may be acceptable for a phone, but definitely not tolerable as a gaming device. So we hook two extra battery cells to the phone, making a total of 9900 mAh battery. To put it in comparison, that's more battery life than iPad Pro. As you can see, all three battery cells are connected in parallel, sharing one protection board. By the way, you will have to discharge all the battery cells to the same level before hooking them up. And also, we will have to modify the software to tell the system the size of the new battery, so Android will manage the battery like it has never been modified. Voila! As we can see in the battery info, our mega battery is good to go. Next, what are we gonna do? The chip. You don't expect me to swap the chip to make an upgrade, right? Well, it's not really an option on smartphone. However, what we can do is overclocking. The factory firmware from Xiaomi has tuned this Snapdragon 855 way too slow, even though the PrimeCore A76 is clocked at 2.8 GHz by default, it will never reach that peak performance in real-world gaming. In fact, it's not even reaching 2 GHz in our Genshin Impact benchmark. That is not acceptable for gaming. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna boost the CPU clock speed by tuning our CPU governor. That could be done by kernel management software after rooting your phone. You can find a bunch of them on Play Store. The one we choose is SmartPack. This fancy little app allowed us to select the maximum and minimum frequency for all three types of cores. And right here, we can change the behavior of the CPU governor. For example, here we are choosing performance mode, which will keep your clock speed as high as possible at all times. And that's for our CPU. For the GPU, we can also try to overclock the hell out of it. This Adreno 640 GPU in our Snapdragon is clocked at 585 MHz by default. And there is a free and open source overclocking tool called Konabase. With this app installed, we can change the voltage and frequency table of our GPU. And upon our testing and trying, we found our GPU can be overclocked to as high as 840 MHz. That's a 40% uplift. 40% of free GPU power with just some taps on your finger. Wow, this little piece of silicon can do much more than I think. And what else can we overclock? The screen! Yeah, you heard me right. The screen on our Mi 9 is also overclockable. You can overclock this 60Hz panel to a higher refresh rate. This is a community-made custom kernel. What you have to do is download this kernel, rename it with a higher refresh rate, and then flash the kernel in your recovery. Our particular device can run stably at 81Hz, but the color accuracy is pretty bad if you do so. So we choose a sweet point at 75Hz. And now I can certainly feel a bit smoother when scrolling through. Just in case you want to try yourself, we put a GitHub link for the software on the description below. All right, so free performance, free refresh rate, they all come with a cost, heat. You see, Xiaomi limits the hardware for a reason. After our lunatic tuning, the phone is burning like hell right now. When the temperature reaches the limit, the phone will lock itself until cooled down. You don't want that happen when you're about to get a chicken dinner, right? So we definitely have to redesign our custom thermal solution. Take a look inside the phone, we can find the SoC on the back of the motherboard, which means the Snapdragon 855 has been sandwiched by the motherboard and the mid-frame. That is not a configuration where heat can easily come out. However, since the heat source is contacting with the aluminum midframe, we can apply some thermal compound, moving the heat to the midframe and bring airflow through it. And let's do it. First, we remove the camera module to expose more midframe to the airflow. Camera, does it even run games? We can definitely ditch that for better thermal and less weight. Then we stick an aluminum cooler with a 40x40mm fan to the back of the motherboard, having sweet air blowing through all the time. To power up the fan, we need to draw power directly from the battery. Well, battery on the phone usually rated as 3.7 volts and will well be a bit higher when fully charged. As we tried, it can still drive this 5-volt fan, but not at full speed. And you know what? We're gonna push everything to its limit, even this tiny little fan. So this is a pre-made DC to DC converter board, which can take 3.7 volts and output 5 volts. We hook this up along with breadboard and two switches so you can manually control it and choose the fan speed you like. And this module is just the right size to fill the gap between the battery and the fans. Pretty cool, huh? Now the thermal solution is ready, we can unleash even more performance by disabling the thermal threshold. This is a community-made MIUI thermal control tool called, well, this is obviously pretty well-mannered. You have five very easy-to-understand modes, with this first one being, you know. By selecting this, Android will no longer care about how hot your phone is. So with our fan running, we are squeezing out every last bit of juice out of this Snapdragon 855. But with all those crazy modifications done, we still have a very important job to do. We need a case. Now we have to design a unique case for this unique phone. And with the help of 3D printing technology, it won't be too hard to manufacture. So the design is pretty straightforward. There are two parts of a case held together by screws. One of the most important things is maintaining airflow while protecting our finger from touching the fan. So here, we only left open the blade part, not the middle part. The gap is small enough so you won't hurt your finger. In terms of airflow, cold air goes into the case from back and then goes through the entire motherboard exhaust to both sides of the phone, so far so good. What's also important is overall shape of the case. I mean, with all the stuff inside, it is really thick and heavy as a phone now. So we definitely want some extra smoothness from the case. We rounded every single corner, making sure no sharp angle can be touched. And now, I think it feels even better than a regular phone by holding. And of course, as a gaming device, it certainly needs to attach a controller. In between these two parts of the case, we reserve some space for a universal accessory mount. And we also designed a controller mount which attaches the phone to an Xbox controller. Since the mount is universal, you can attach more stuff on it like a speaker, or a power bank, or anything you can think of. So that is our design, and it's time to print that out. We first tried our FDM printer, and that is just not so great. In first couple trial, we got some failed example like this one due to temperature difference between day and night. Even when the printing process goes smooth, the final result is still pretty rough. You can literally see and feel every single layer right here. It's just not feeling like a premium device, right? So we give up on FDM and purchase 3D printing service online. They will manufacture our design by SLA technology, where they're using precise set of laser to solidify resin. And this is our final production. It costs 60 yuan, roughly about 10 bucks. And that worth every single penny. I mean, look at it. So smooth, so much better than what we have done. What a nice job. And after putting them all together, that is the gaming device we're talking about. At this point, everything has been done on this phone. So what is the cost? Total cost, including the phone, we spend 910 yuan in total. It's about 150 US dollars. It might be a bit more expensive in your region, but definitely way cheaper than the new flagship. It is quite a bargain for a gaming device, right? But how it really performs? It's time to test everything out. First, we tried 3DMark Wildlife Extreme. This is a GPU benchmark, and the 40% overclock we put on it actually translates to a 40% performance boost. Yes, this GPU is on par with the newest Snapdragon A70. And more importantly, with the fan running at full speed, our GPU does not throttle at all. The stress test reported a whopping 98% stability. Yes, no throttling at all on full load. And maybe it's time to step into some real gaming. I mean, seriously demanding games like Genshin Impact. Just for comparison, a standard unmodified Mi 9 averaged at only 39 FPS under high preset. And if we check the CPU frequency, well, it is very, very slow. With the CPU core all below 1.7 GHz, no wonder why the game is so laggy. So now, let me introduce our Mi 90 Pro. Oh wow! With proper tweaking, this old lady can even run at over 50 FPS. That's a whopping 25% performance increase. And now the game is running way smoother than before. It's now feeling like a real gaming phone. In fact, it's even faster than some nowadays flagships like Mi 12 Pro. Look at that! Our Snapdragon 855 is even faster than the latest Snapdragon 8. How ironic is that? And what's more interesting is the power efficiency. This 855 consuming about 6.5 watts at 50 FPS, where Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 consuming 6.8 watts, delivering the same performance. Is that what you call a flagship, Qualcomm? Flagship my ass. But to make it more like a proper gaming handheld, we still need a controller. So we printed an adapter, and with that, we can attach an Xbox controller underneath, and now this Mi 90 Pro looks like a pro. However, the Android version of Genshin Impact doesn't natively support controller yet, so we have to use this little app called Mantis Gamepad Pro to map the touchscreen with these controller buttons. And we're gonna have to register every single button and the joystick. But look at the bright side, everything is configurable. You can even use a controller and touchscreen at the same time. I would say it's even better than the official controller support on the iOS version. So we kinda nailed it in Genshin Impact. Maybe you should try some even crazier game. This is Alien Isolation, a real AAA title released back in 2014, and recently it has been ported to Android. Because the game originally runs on PC, every single graphic setting can be modified. By editing the config file, you can even unlock some PC level graphics. Like by default, the game runs at 30 frames per second, but here we can unlock the frame rate to 75. Yeah, that's our refresh rate. And it just works. The frame rate definitely goes above 60s. Well, when actually playing, we got only 40-ish. Yeah, it's a PC game, so it is still pretty demanding. I should know it. However, the graphic quality is also PC level. Even we are only at 720p res right now, it looks pretty nice. But we just can't get enough. Remember when I said we can modify the config file? Yes, we are doing exactly that. Doubling our resolution to 1080p and enable every single option like reflection, ambient occlusion, particles, and... Well, you wouldn't believe it. Here we have only 15 FPS. Wow, what a huge appetite. That is what we call demanding, huh? But look at the graphics, the shadows, the lights, the fire, the smokes. It just grudges us. I think we just squeezed the last bit of juice out of this Mi 90 Pro now. Other than Android ports, we can also try some emulators like EtherSX2. This is a PS2 emulator for Android. It should be quite demanding for regular phones, but not our Mi 90 Pro. We tried Gran Turismo 4, and the phone runs at 60 FPS under 1080p scaling with no problem. Easy peasy. And also, my personal favorite, Hitman Blood Money. Back in the day, the game is famous for its freedom and playability. Yes, you can eliminate your enemy, put on his clothes, and put his body into a fridge. Classic. When running on our Mi 90 Pro, this game is apparently more demanding than Gran Turismo. We can only get 30-ish FPS at around 900p resolution. But there were more power-hungry titles on PS2. Let me introduce God of War 2. This game was released in 2007 when PS3 is already out for a year. And at the end of the lifespan of PS2, this game really utilized every single bit of performance of the console. On this Mi 90 Pro, we can only run smoothly at 480p, which is the original resolution. But still, play such a classic title on a smartphone, that is really exciting. Alright, that's all for today's video. We built our own gaming handheld with overclocking, custom battery, and custom cooling. It runs as fast as a modern flagship where it only costs a quarter of the price. And this whole process of building this thing is just a hell lot of fun. And if you like our video, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. We'll have more interesting projects like this. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.